In architecting the data store and the computational resources that back the data store at a server, a system administrator has a choice of either replicating or partitioning the data. If you're replicating the data, what that means is that every data server has the full corpus of data that is needed to serve a particular request. Think of it as, say, Gmail. If it is Gmail, then if a Gmail request gets sent to any one of these servers, they can handle the request that comes in because they have the full corpus of data to deal with the incoming request. We mentioned that failures are inevitable in giant scale services because of the number of computation elements that live within a data center. If failures occur, what happens when we have replicated data? What that means is that the harvest is going to be unchanged because even if some data repositories failed, because it is replicated, we can redirect a client request to another live server that has full access to the data repository. And therefore, the harvest that you're going to get with replication is 100%. It is unaffected. On the other hand, because the server capacity has come down due to these failures, the yield is going to come down. In other words, with replication, the service is unavailable for some users for some amount of time. But all the users that are able to get the service get complete harvest in terms of the fidelity for the query that is returned and answered by the server. The other alternative, of course, for architecting the internal data repository of a server is to partition the data. So if you partition the data, and let's say that there are n partitions of the full corpus of data, and let's say that some of the servers fail, then some portion of the full corpus of data becomes unavailable. If this happens, what it means is that the harvest is going to be down because some portion of the data corpus is unavailable, and therefore the harvest is going to come down, but it is possible to keep Q unchanged. So long as the computational capacity is unchanged, then we can serve the same number of user community. It's just that the fidelity of the result may not be as good as when all of the data corpus is available. For example, if this is a server that is serving search results, and if some portion of the data repository is unavailable, in that case, each query that comes in will get service, but it is going to get a subset of the query results for the search that they are doing. So the important message that I want to convey through these pictures is that DQ is independent of whether we are replicating or we are partitioning the data. Given a certain server capacity, the DQ is a constant because we are assuming that disk is cheap, disk space is cheap, and therefore processing incoming requests are not disk bound, but it is network bound. The only exception is if the queries result in significant write traffic to the disk. Now, this is rare in giant scale services, but if that happens, then replication may require more DQ than partitioning. But as a first order of approximation, so long as we assume that giant scale services are serving client requests which are network bound, the DQ is independent of the strategy that is used by the system administrator for managing the data, whether it is replication or partitioning. Now, what this also means is that this is giving an object lesson to the system administrator in saying that beyond a certain point, you probably want to replicate than partition. Why? Because failures are bound to happen. And if failures are bound to happen, if you partition the data, then a portion of the data corpus becomes unavailable. On the other hand, if beyond a certain point, even if you have partitioned data, if you replicate it, then you're making sure that even if one replica is down, some other replica of the same partition is available for serving a particular client request. And replication beyond a certain point is important because users would normally prefer complete data or a complete harvest. Take, for instance, you're accessing your email through the internet. You would rather put up with a service being unavailable for some amount of time rather than seeing that you only have access to a portion of your mailbox. And that's the reason why replication beyond a certain point is better for dealing with giant scale services. On the other hand, for searches, it may be okay to have a harvest which is not complete. So in structuring different services as a giant scale service, one has to make a decision of whether partitioning is the right approach or at what point we may want to partition and then replicate as well. As a concrete example, Inktomi, which is a CDN server, uses partial replication. It uses full replication for email because of what I just said, and that is a user would expect complete harvest for a service like email. But on the other hand, if it is a web cache that is being implemented as a giant scale service, it is okay if it is not replicated.